Hi, have you ever got crazy ideas such as tying a rope around the earth along its equator? I know, it's kinda absurd to actually think to do it. But what goes in imagining? I would actually like you to imagine it. Why I'm asking this is because I have a very interesting question to ask you in this regard. Imagine tying a rope tightly around the earth along the equator. Like this. You'd need 40,075 km long rope to do it, the circumference of the equator being 40,075 km. You now lengthen the rope by 6 feet, that is add 6 feet, which is only nearly a human length, to the 40,075 km long rope. By doing this, you lengthen it by only 0.000045%. Then you position this loose rope around the equator in such a way that it is uniformly spaced off the globe. Like this. Now the question is, will a mouse fit under the rope? Think. Get your thinking brains to work. Well, okay. Do pause the video to think of the solution. I'm going to tell you what the answer is and how you can get to the answer. The answer is yes. You can actually fit a mouse under the rope. And not only can you fit a mouse under it, but you can also fit a small rabbit under it. Astonishing, isn't it? You added less than 2 meters to 40,075 km long rope. It is such a negligible increase, and yet it lifted the rope off the ground by almost 1 foot. This is the point where intuition and maths don't go hand in hand. Let's see how this happens. Let this circle represent the circumference of the circle formed when the rope is tied tightly around the equator of the earth. And this circle represent the circle when the rope is lengthened by 6 feet and repositioned like said. Let the circumference and radius of the inner circle be C and R1 respectively. And those of outer circle be C plus 6 because you have lengthened the rope by 6 feet and R2 respectively. So, in asking what the question asks, it basically asks for the difference between radii of the outer circle and the inner circle. This difference between radii of the circles is given by R2 minus R1. There are again two ways we can get this. One is traditional way and another is a clever easy way, which I'll be showing after we are done with the traditional way. You can use this clever method for ease in calculation in future too. Let's first do it the traditional way. Let's consider the inner circle. Here, C equals to 2 pi R1, because that's the formula for circumference of the circle. Therefore, R1 equals to C by 2 pi. Let this be question 1. Now, let's consider the outer circle. Here, C plus 6 equals to 2 pi R2. R2 then will be equal to C plus 6 by 2 pi. Let this be equation 2. Subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, we'll get R2 minus R1 equals to 6 by 2 pi equals to 0.95 feet, which is equal to 11.5 inches. Which is nearly equal to 1 foot. Even only 5 inch space would be sufficient for a mouse to crawl under. So it seems not only one mouse, but at least 4 mice can crawl under it, stacked on top of the other. Isn't it interesting? By lengthening a 40,075 km long rope by 6 feet, or by 0.0000045% or by the height of a human being, we can lift off the equator by about 1 foot. Did you notice that the end result did not include the circumference of the Earth? It only required the length of added rope and pi. Since it didn't include circumference, we can say that the solution is not dependent on the circumference of the Earth. Once we know this, we can hire a method more elegant, easy and quick to solve it. This elegant method of solving is a very powerful problem-solving strategy and is called considering extreme cases. Wanna know how? Okay. So, because our problem requires us to find the difference between the radii, what we'll do is, suppose the inner circle or the equator of the Earth is very small. So small that its radius is zero, which means it is just a point. This time, the difference between the radius of the bigger circle and that of a smaller circle is R2 minus R1 equals to R2 minus 0 equals to R2. Now, all we need to do is to find the radius of the outer circle and our problem will be solved. To find out the radius of the outer circle, we apply the formula for circumference of the larger circle. Here, circumference of the larger circle is C plus 6 and radius is R2. Let's not forget that the circumference of the smaller circle is 0, making C equals to 0. Therefore, C plus 6 equals to 2 pi R2, replacing C with 0 because the circumference of the inner circle is 0, we get 0 plus 6 equals to 2 pi R2 or R2 equals to 6 by 2 pi, which is 11.5 inches, which is the same as the answer we found out by traditional method. But this method is quick, easy and elegant, isn't it? Now, from what we did today, we must understand that the increase in radius of a circle is not dependent on the initial circumference. What it means is, even if you add 6 feet to a circle with perimeter 1 foot, the result is going to be the same. That is, the new radius is going to increase by 11.5 inches or nearly 1 foot, as in the previous case. Now suppose something far bigger than Earth, like Jupiter. If you do the same thing even around Jupiter, the increase in radius with 6 feet increase in circumference is going to be 11.5. Be it a P, Earth or Jupiter, an increase of 6 feet in circumference is going to yield an increase of 11.5 inches in the radius. So, this video helped you find two little marvelous gems. First, it reveals a stunning result not many of us would have thought of. And second, it provides you with a cool problem-solving strategy known as considering extreme cases, which forms a basis for you to solve similar problems in the future. Like and subscribe for more interesting videos. Do comment for your opinions about the video. Also share this video with your family and friends so that even they can enjoy this astonishment.